Hey guys, Hermit here, and today I want to talk to you about Capture One Express, particularly for Fujifilm cameras. So that's the X series cameras and their GFX line as well. This free software essentially means that you can catalog your photos using Capture One Express. You can edit your photos. Now the editing is very basic editing, which is what I'm going to talk about in a bit more detail. And I'm going to talk about the pros and cons of what's available in this version versus what's available in Lightroom as a standard software. So I have loaded up a bunch of RAW files, JPEG files from my Fujifilm X-T2 camera, which are in the catalog of Capture One. The good thing now is that I think earlier versions didn't support this, but Capture One 11, I'm not sure from which version, but I can certainly say for Capture One 11 that it does support photos sitting on networked drives. These photos here from this Melbourne folder, these are sitting on my Drobo 5N, and they are loaded straight from the network. And when I click through, you can see the image renders fairly quickly. So there's really no lag or any latency or any issues with using Capture One and networked photos on NAS, for example, like Drobo. We've also got some other pictures here that I have loaded up, and I have also experimented by importing a Canon RAW file. Now I can preview this, and I guess you have the eye icon, which means you can only see it. However, if I go to this quick panel, I think that's what that means, Q for quick edit, I see all the sliders that are grayed out because obviously this is not a Fujifilm file. However, if I switch to any of these, I can modify any of those settings. So let's take a look around the interface. You can add various different folders and import photos from them. So I have added folder 08. From my 2017 photos. This is sitting in my Drobo, and that's imported 36 photos. And also on an SSD that I have imported some random photos that I took in Tasmania, and I've basically imported them into this catalog. You've also got the functionality, just like Lightroom, to be able to rate your photos. So here you can see the various different rating options, and you can search and filter by them. You can also see by keywords. So I went ahead and keyworded some of these photos, and that's what these icons mean. These are keyworded images. So if I want to look at Tasmania photos, those are the only ones from Tasmania. If I want to look at travel photos, those are the six that I see. They are the same because I'm selected around here in this folder, Capture One, which has only got seven photos. If I go up here, then it starts to make a little bit more sense. I can see all of my photos that I have imported down here. And if I want to see Melbourne photos, I click on that and it filters all the photos from Melbourne. If I want to see all my travel photos, these are all my travel photos here. Okay, so it is very similar to Lightroom. It has its pros and cons. It is a free version, so there are some limitations in what you can or can't do in this particular version. So things like, take this photo for example, this one here. I go into this interface, quick edit, and I have done some adjustments here. So let's reset everything. And once I've reset that, I can start editing this image. So if I want to pull up the exposure, or open up the shadows, I can only go from 0 to 100, as in opening up the shadows. I can't pull them down, I can't make them any darker. For example, if I go to this image, which is a brighter version of the same shot, if I want to darken the shadows, I can't pull that any further, which you can do in Lightroom. Now, highlights go from 0 to 100, but they only go in one direction, as in recovery of the highlights. You can't add more highlights if you wanted to. So that's another variation from Lightroom. The other panels here obviously are exposure contrast. The brightness is kind of like the white slider in Lightroom, but what you have missing here is the black slider in Lightroom. You don't have the option to drag the blacks. If you want to pull the blacks down a bit more, then you have to go to the curve section, which is somewhere here.
And basically then you can darken the blacks by pulling that, or you can pull that point across and you can darken again the blacks. So that's, I mean, it's not bad. You can still get away with editing the photo like you want. The one main thing, which is why I will not use this version, even though this is free and Lightroom is a paid subscription, is that there are no brushes. The brushes are only available in their pro version. So for example, if you want to mask this certain area with a brush tool, or if you want to apply in this image a gradient, graduated gradient here to essentially darken the sky, you cannot do that in this particular free version. So you can do very basic editing. You have access to curves. You can also load up profiles and you can apply various different profiles. Now there's an online article which has been shared, and I'll put the link in the description, that allows you to download these various different profiles so you can apply them on your photos. Other than that, basically you have the very basic editing tools available: clarity, structure, all of those options are there. Curves are there. You can adjust the levels. You can pull the levels, I guess, to darken the blacks as well, which I was doing with the curves. So overall, as a free solution, I think it's a really good solution to get you started. But soon you will find that some of the functionality that you want or you need to edit some photos, particularly where you want to do selective adjustments. For example, here, if I just want to darken the sky and leave this area brighter, I can't do that. I have to darken the whole image. And therefore, you know, that will either force you to purchase their pro version. So this is, as I mentioned, this is the express version for Fujifilm cameras. You can get their pro version, and that's a paid one-time license, and that will give you the added functionalities of adjustment brushes and so on. The other thing that's a little bit different, and it's not good or bad, is that there is no before and after option for the entire image. If I have played around with various different settings here, I can only do before and after by holding the Alt key or Option key on the Mac and pressing this reset button. And press and hold that button, I can see the before and after. For the exposure panel, I can do before and after. I can't do the entire image as such. I have to use the individual panel option to see the before and after. So I can't do an entire combined before and after. Now, if I just don't know it, but I have Googled around and there doesn't seem to be a global option. I believe that is there in the pro version, that you have an arrow like this at the top, so it does that for the entire image. But in this free version, that option is not available.
All right, so that's pretty much it on Capture One Express. I wanted to just give you an introduction on what is available, what you can do with this software. As a free software that you are licensed to use, it's not a trial, so head over to their website. I'll put a link in the description down below and download this software. If you don't want to use Lightroom or you don't have Lightroom, give this software a try, see if you like it, and if you do, you can pay for their licensed version, which I think is about $370. I'll put the exact price in the video, but that $370 was a perpetual license, which means that you don't have to pay for subscription again and again. You own that software. However, I don't know how many updates does that include. Is that just for 1 year? Is it just one more update? Then you might have to pay again for the upgrade price. Now, take this with a grain of salt, essentially, and make your own decision. For me, definitely Capture One is worth a try. I have tried it in the past. Not something that I will use. I just don't find myself excited about this software as much as I am about Lightroom. And I'm quite comfortable in using Lightroom, a lot of the basic editing all the way to pretty advanced editing in Lightroom. So for me, Lightroom is the only software I'll use to manage my catalog, but just wanted to show you guys what you can do with this software. So hope you found this video useful. If you did, give it a thumbs up. And yeah, I'll see you soon in another video. Oh, before I go, if you're not subscribed, hit that subscribe button and subscribe to my channel. There'll be more videos coming very soon. So I'll see you soon in another video. Take care. Bye-bye.